Hi guys, another Diablo 4 video. Let's get it. Okay, so this time it's season 5, so I thought I'd do a video on the way that I found the quickest way to get the Resplendent Spark, so you can hopefully try and get 4 of them as quickly as possible and start crafting your Ubers. The only difference with this one is you do need a boost. You do need someone that's high level. A level 100 is preferable, but if not, just someone that's strong enough to take down the Hell Tides. If you're struggling and you do need help, you need someone to help you do it, leave a comment, leave your battle pass and your comment in the comment, and I'll get back to you and I'll give you a boost, no problem at all. I can do that. I've got plenty of level 100 characters. My hardcore is even nearly 100, so if anyone needs a hardcore boost as well, I can do that. But for now, let's concentrate on this one. So, as always with these boosts, it doesn't really matter which character you use, but I always use a Necromancer because it means your minions can do a lot of the work for you as well. So you just select your character, you can finalise it, you don't need to mess about. Obviously you want to skip the campaign. I'll just call it BT because it's boost. Start the game, seasonal realm obviously, and then you want to start on world tier 2 obviously. What I'll do is I'll come back now when I'm at the point when I'm about to go to world tier 3. I'll still play the game, you just don't want to hear my voice. I'll still play the game with a timestamp, so you've got an idea of some being truthful to the how long it takes to get one Resplendent Spark. Let's go.
Did I just hear for that trying food?
I saw the weak made strong. A pack of lambs feasting on wolves.
Wait.
It was something
my... We'll light a candle for you.
I need time to do that.
The Wanderer is on us!
Everyone be calm!
Calm? I invited the Wanderer to be our guest.
Our what?
We are their mother. Oh, blessed mother. To begin, we offer a taste of the mother's power. Your birthright.
Oh, sure, why not? Take a basic sacrifice. Nothing too unsavory. Go on and fetch me one of them Khazra livers. Make sure it's ripe.
No power comes without sacrifice. We take what is necessary to...
Enough! Go on, Wanderer. Chop up! Your power's inside.
Damn it, it's still!
Nothing. Try a bigger one. Here she is. A paltry taste of the power the mother promised. You enjoy it.
This is the mother's gift. Lethal to most, but those who have taken her sacred blood will feel it awaken inside them.
Yes, well, it's the only gift you'll get from me. You want more, you'll have to earn them. Look here.
Now.
Okay, so at this point now, your character, which is the one there, which is this one here, this is the character you're boosting, doesn't need to move from this area until you get to the end bosses of the capstones. As you can see, I've got this game on PlayStation, PC and Xbox and mobile, I think, somewhere. I just love this game. But anyway, it's easier for me to edit if I use both of my accounts, so it's easily done. I've got dual monitors, so, I mean, never mind all that. So anyway, so this character is going to do all the leveling, and then this character just needs to fast travel when he gets to the boss, because all you want to do is move up the world tiers. You want to get to world tier 4 as quickly as possible. It's not an XP grind, it's a mother's the mother's token things, a grind. That's what you want. Okay, now you can tag along if you're doing this with someone else if you want, but you don't really need it. You don't need the loot, you don't need the XP, and you'll get enough XP when we get into the hell tides anyway. So from this point on now, this character stays here. When this character gets to the last boss of the two world tier bosses, this character will fast travel over and then just get the reward for leveling up, and then we'll move on from there. Okay, so at this point now, it's all about getting these mother's gifts, and we want to get to a level 20, and we're going to do that inside them infernal hordes. Now, you can do it on World Tier 3, but with World Tier 3, you only get 4 points per spark that you pick up, whereas in World Tier 4, you get 16 points, so obviously it's better to do that if you can. If you can't, if you're not strong enough and you're only going to do World Tier 3, that's fine, you can craft lots of World Tier 3 ones, but you want World Tier 4, really. So that's it now, so we're just going to get in there, we're going to rinse and repeat, I'll speed through it, and we'll get it done as quickly as we can. Obviously, it'd be a little bit quicker if there was two of you doing it, but because it's just me on my own, it's a little bit slower, but not that much slower, so we'll just get it and get things done. Let's go. Okay, so that's basically it. If you go down, just stay down. You're not farming XP, you're not farming loot, you're just farming these little orb things. And that's why you get your pet, because look, your pet will pick a lot of them up for you. You can pick these ones up as well, these red ones, if you want. Because at the end you can transfer them for gold or things like that. And it's gold is account shared. So you just pick them all up. See, look, I'm tier 6 already. So I'm going from tier 2 to tier 6 in one run. So yeah, so that's it really. You just get your and then you just come back, sweat here, and then let your other character or your other player, whoever is working with you, do the rest. So I'll just fly through it now, so we can get a bit of a time scale and see how long it's actually taken to get to tier 20. Let's go. Okay, so two runs, and we've gone up 10 levels, so we're halfway through. Obviously, it's going to start getting a little bit harder because the XP gap, is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger the higher we get. But for two runs, with 10 tiers, and we've got a few of those compasses there as well, so that'll help with the grind. So yeah, onwards and upwards. We'll probably get to like two, and then it'll be one per run and things like that. So we'll just keep going till it's finished and keep the timer running.
Thank you. I don't care.
Okay, so that's it done. I'm not entirely sure what the time was. I'll know when I edit the video. But that was definitely very, very quick. That was definitely quicker than season 4. So yeah, so for those who don't know, it's for that you want the Resplendent Spark that you'll get out of that cache. And then what you do then is you come to the Alchemist. And then it'll let you craft any one of these, but you need 50 million as well in gold. So obviously the quickest way is to get them to drop from the bosses, from the uber bosses. But one, like I said in my old video, it's the same old, it's RNG and whether or not you got the build. If your RNG isn't that great, and the materials as well, sorry, you need materials to enable them to spawn. So if those three aren't your thing, then you can definitely craft them. Like I said, that field very, very quick. It won't be surprised if it's around 4 hours, and in season 4 it was 6 hours. That's how long that took. So that's definitely an improvement. So the video footage of me, that's me doing it by myself. I thought it would also have been unfair of me to ask somebody else to sit around whilst I'm doing all this editing and things like that as well. So, and all these little video clips and things like that. So, that was pretty good. I mean, as you can see, I got to level 73 as well, just by doing nothing really, just by the character just stood there whilst my other character did all the legwork. I'll print up on the screen now exactly how long it took, how many runs it took, and then obviously we've got to level 73. So I'll probably carry on this character, but you don't need to. What you want to do is you want to delete it and start another one and do that 4 times to craft one piece. And like I said, if it's around 4 hours, you could do them easily in a day, like, you know what I mean, no problem whatsoever. You know what I mean, that would be ideal. I managed to do it in a day last time, and that was at 6 hours. So 4 hours, you've definitely, you know what I mean, you're gonna be laughing. You could do one a day and have all as many as the ubers as you want. So that's it. Hope this helped. Like I said, I'll print up the details, but the reason for doing that as well is so that you'll know if you need to craft any of the compasses that you might need. I was lucky. I mean, I had enough. I think I've got about four or so spare as well. So and like I said, if you need help, if you need a carry to do what I've just done here, let me know in the comments, and I'll try my best to help out as many people as I can. So yeah, enjoy.